Hey people of the interwebs, it is Q with another scuba diving adventure. Wednesday morning, 7:20 a.m, 24 degrees outside already, and expected to get a high of around about 33 degrees by lunchtime. Today's dive adventure is a little bit different. I'm going to be diving two dives on a hunk of metal that's 133 meters long, weighs 3,370 tons, and is home to over 200 species of different fish. So stick around and find out exactly what we're going to be doing.
This is the Mooloolaba Marina. It's the home of Scubaworld, and today I'm going out on one of their regular trips to scuba dive on the ex-HMAS Brisbane, a modified Perth-class guided missile destroyer, which was decommissioned in 2001 and then scuttled into her final resting place in July 2005. But before we gear up and get into the water, there's the obligatory dive brief to attend.
It's very easy for navigation. You only need to remember two things for navigation. One, stay on the big metal thing. And the second thing is, because you're starting your dive at the bow of the Brisbane, you instinctively start travelling towards the stern. So at some stage, do one 180-degree turn and start turning back to going back to where you came from. Very, very straightforward.
Whether you're diving with just your buddies or a commercial operator like Scubaworld, a dive brief is an essential part of safety, where you'll pick up information about depth, current, visibility, tides, and of course, more importantly, how to navigate the dive site. The wreck of the Brisbane is acclaimed as a world-class dive site by many divers from around the world, and I was eager to take a look-see. As we headed out of the marina and through the navigation channel, I thought it was a good time to share with my dive group a very special technique that I use to make my air last longer.
If my air is low and his air is low, then we'll come up together, and then
I grab a fish and suck air out of them and throw them away. Yeah, that's my technique and it works for me. Just squeeze it, yeah, that's right.
On this day, the current was running at around about 1 or 1.5 knots. As we descended the mooring line, it looked like visibility was around about 10 to 12 meters, but as we got deeper, it dropped to around about 6 to 8 meters. but still, that was enough to be able to see where we were going and navigate the wreck safely. I was in a group with three other experienced divers, and we also had our own dive guide, Rachel, who did a fantastic job of showing us around. The visibility on this dive site is changeable throughout the year, and there are times when you can be on the surface, look down, and see the wreck quite clearly about 15 or 16 metres below you. However, on this day, the Brisbane was keeping herself shrouded in mystery until we got right on top of her. In preparation for her sinking, the Brisbane was filled with 250 tons of concrete and 38 small explosive charges were carefully positioned to ensure that she sank facing into the ocean currents and sat perfectly upright on her keel. Once the explosives were detonated, it took just 2 minutes and 10 seconds to sink. Some of the taller parts of the ship have been removed, but she's still 8 stories high and 7 cricket pitches long. That's 133 meters or 436 feet. No matter how many times I descend an anchor or mooring line, when the visibility is like this, I always get that feeling in the back of my mind that it's just gonna go on forever and ever. But eventually, out of the blue-grey haze, a darker shape began to appear. It had taken a full 4 minutes to descend the mooring line to the forward deck of the Brisbane at 15.4 meters, which is 50.5 feet. Also interesting to note, the temperature here was 26 degrees Celsius, which is 78.8 Fahrenheit. But a little bit later on in the video, when I drop down to the keel at 28 meters or 92 feet, there's a very noticeable 2-degree difference in the water temperature. As I was the first of my group to arrive on the forward deck, I turned back towards the mooring line and watched my buddies appear out of the haze. Once everyone was settled in, we set off in search of adventure. Our plan was to descend the smokestack into the bowels of the ship and take a good look around. After 12 years of sitting on the bottom, there's quite a lot of plant and animal growth on the Brisbane, but you can still make out the shape of everything. Here you can see us passing over the top of the forward gun. One of the things we were told during the dive brief was to expect some up-close and personal encounters with what they called the black scale fish. Now, these little fellas are very territorial and they're not shy in letting you know that you're in their zone and they want you out. At first, it can be a little bit disconcerting having them come and nip at you, but after a while, it just becomes funny when you think about the size of this small fish compared to the size of a diver and how many times they must have to defend their territory. They're all over the ship and there's no escaping them. As we continued upwards and heading towards the stern of the boat, we could see evidence of other divers already inside the superstructure. I've got to give marks of 10 out of 10 to the guys who prepared the Brisbane as a wreck dive before they sank her. There are access holes all along the structure, which allow easy passage into the forward engine room, the boiler room, gun mount, and the ship's interior, including the living and sleeping quarters used by the crew during the ship's service. Entry, exit, and navigation is just so simple. Arriving at the smokestack, it seemed like this was the place to be in the fishy world, with lots of different species interacting. You can enter the smokestack directly from above or through the scuba diver sized holes on the side. If you can squeeze yourself past the fish, that is. Any words that I use here are not going to adequately describe the sensation and feeling of navigating through the wreck, so I'll just sit back and let you enjoy. The Brisbane is a very big ship, and it would take many dives to be able to discover all of the secrets that she's hiding both inside and out. Depending on what time of year you come to dive the Brisbane, the water temperatures can range from 17 degrees Celsius in the winter to a summer high of 27 degrees Celsius. And visibility averages around about the 15 meter mark, but sometimes can get up to 20 meters or more. Rachel, our dive guide, was keeping an eye on everyone's air consumption. And just as we reached the stern gun turret, she gave us the signal to turn around and head back towards the mooring line on the forward deck. Back at the mooring line, I checked my air and still had plenty left, so I indicated to Rachel that I was going to head down to the keel and get some video footage. The wreck of the Brisbane sits in a desert. There's nothing but sand for 150 metres all around. However, once you do get to the keel, sometimes you can get lucky and see some of the larger marine animals that live here, including bull rays, shovel-nose rays, and the ever-famous Queensland groper. However, on this day, there was nothing but me, the ship, and the sand. After my brief trip to the bottom, I headed back up to the forward deck and rejoined my group, where we had a few more minutes to look around before we started heading back up the mooring line. At 55 bar and 32 minutes later, it was time to head back up the mooring line and do the boring bit. That was sitting at 5 meters for 3 minutes as a safety stop.
So I've got to finish this off on the phone. 64 gigabyte SD card got completely full around about halfway through the second dive. I'm not sure exactly what footage we've got, but I guess we'll find out. So, fantastic day. Split this into two videos, hopefully. So, we'll get one up this Saturday and one up next Saturday. Enjoy. It's a good trip, good day out.
If you enjoyed this scuba diving adventure with Q, please subscribe to the YouTube channel to see all my other scuba diving videos. Leave a like on the ones you do like. Don't forget to leave your comments as well. As soon as I see those, I'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and take it easy.